L'Accusé de Rocha is a novel set in a very small village in the Scottish Highlands in the 19th century, in 1869. It tells the story of a very violent triple murder which takes place in the village. And the murderer is a young farmer called Roddy McRae. Quite an ordinary, he's just a teenager. But he's driven to commit this terrible crime. And the book is constructed as a series of documents. So we have Roddy's memoir that he writes in prison about the events leading up to the murders. We have a psychiatric report into Roddy's mental state. We have a report on the trial and different witness statements. So I'm kind of giving the reader a sort of puzzle with different pieces and accounts. So it's for the reader to fit together and decide what motivated the crime, whether Roddy is guilty or not. So the reader kind of plays detective in the book. I mean, the book was inspired really by two things. And one of them actually was the French case of Pierre Riviere, who was a French peasant. And in 1835, he killed three members of his own family, his mother, sister, and brother. But the remarkable thing about this case was that while in prison, he wrote an account of the events leading up to the murders. And I've always been fascinated by the contrast between this violence and his ability to write about them. So that was the beginning of the idea for the book. And the other side was that my mother's side of my family comes from the north of Scotland, so it's a place I know very well. It's a very beautiful place, but it has a very dark history and a kind of culture that people don't speak about very much. So I've kind of brought those two things together. I did a lot of research for the book, historical research, general history into the social conditions of the time, which were really shocking. This is a very, very poor place where people lived in terrible conditions. I read psychiatric reports on criminals, old cases, so I could read the letters written by murderers from Scottish prisons. Really fascinating documents, and that stuff really fires my imagination. So a lot of research, but it's because I want the reader to feel that this is real. And I think whenever you read a novel, whether it's completely fiction or not, my book is completely fiction, but I want the reader to feel that it's authentic. As a reader, I engage with character. And as a writer, I want to create characters, because I think that's what draws us into a story. I want the reader to feel something for my character, even although he's committed these terrible crimes. All the social background to the book is there. And I think, yeah, you read the book, you feel really angry about the conditions that these people lived under. And that's good. But my primary motivation is to create the characters, to create the vivid setting, and to tell the story. My first novel in the UK is just about to be published in France. It's going to be called La Disparition d'Adèle Bedeau. And actually, it's set in a small town in the Alsace, a town called Saint-Louis, which I visited many years ago. And Saint-Louis is a very ordinary town. But when I visited it, I was fascinated by this feeling of ordinariness. I come from a small town myself, so I created these characters who live there. And it's a kind of crime novel. There's a detective, Georges Gorski. But really, again, what I'm most interested in is the ambience of the town and the psychology of the characters. The action of this novel takes place inside the head of the character. It's about his thought processes, his guilt, his paranoia, and the minutiae of the life in this small town. So that's coming out in August in France. So it'll be really interesting to see how French readers respond to a Scottish guy's book about France.